Christina and I have just purchased this three-bedroom flip in Anaheim, California that we bought for $340,000. We've completed the demo, but we've already run into an issue because the second bathroom isn't up to code.
So the toilet and the sink are too close together.
That's it.
There's got to be another solution.
Oh, I wonder if this would work. You know, like when we visited your grandma in Belgium, how the bathrooms are tiny and they have those like little sinks that just go against the corner right here? Would something like that work? Just a small like corner sink?
That's not a bad idea. I think we'd be able to get the clearance we need.
If we can get the clearance, I mean, that's a home run. Please tell me.
I think we're in business.
No way.
Yeah.
Great idea.
With the bathroom figured out, we're clearing out all the junk from the weird outdoor space.
Dang, I didn't realize how big it was back here. Oh my God, that thing was huge.
Yeah, it was.
It actually looks like a yard now.
Looks so much better. This is actually a nice yard.
No, there's a two-car garage in the front. If someone wanted to, they can actually use this as parking.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
What's going on, Jake?
Yo, what's up, guys?
Man, it looks huge in here.
When can we take this down, though, the wall?
As soon as we get temporary walls up, we can do that. You know, we're putting in a beam up top, which brings me to a point. We have a little problem.
What's that?
Somebody poured concrete in our footings before we got them inspected.
What do you mean, the subcontractor did?
Yeah.
So they were supposed to come out and then it was supposed to be poured?
Yes. See the concrete that was just poured? That is to support the beam that's going in.
Right.
The work was done, the city never came out. Now it's dried and they can't see what was done.
So until then, the wall can't come down?
Correct.
This was a big mistake and it could also cost us a lot of time and money if the inspector forces us to redo the footings. Fingers crossed that we don't need to so we can move forward removing the wall.
All right, you wanna figure out this kitchen layout then?
Let's do it.
So right now we have sink, dishwasher, stove, microwave, removing the window.
Correct.
Okay, so here's my only question, right? So we have to think curb appeal from the outside.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is a huge window in the front of the house. Is it gonna look weird if we close it up?
I think it's better to get the cabinet space that you guys want.
I 100% agree. This is taking over the whole kitchen. The outside will look fine. We can, you know,
we'll come up with something pretty. Yeah.
Where's the fridge?
Fridge goes here.
Okay.
Much better.
Anything else in here? I think we got it.
Let's do it.
Thankfully, the city signed off and they approved the footings. So we were able to move forward installing the beam that will really open up the space.
Hey.
Hey, honey. Good news on the footings, actually. They just left it as is and we got approved.
Great news.
So what do you got there?
So I have some really cool samples. All right.
In budget.
In budget.
Good.
Check them out. Flooring.
Okay, I like that.
Countertops. We have like kind of a Calcutta marble.
That's
has a little
nice.
Bit of gold hints in it.
Okay.
And then backsplash, oversized subway.
Yeah, this is really cool. White cabinets, right?
Yes. So. You're gonna love it once it's in. All right, I'm gonna go get the kids.
All right, love you.
Love you. Hey, Jake.
Hey, hey.
Babe.
Yeah?
Come out here.
What's going on?
I have some paint samples.
Okay.
Okay, so you know how the roof's kind of like brown?
Oh yeah, it is, okay.
So I was thinking this color for the bricks, this color for the trim, and then this color for the front door.
I actually like the color scheme. So I think that'll look cool and I think it goes with the roof. My big concern still is this thing. We removed the window and now we just, it's obviously supposed to be framing something.
Right.
You know, it's not like we can put brick here. I mean, what do we do?
That's a problem. It's like, how do you match this brick? You couldn't.
I mean, we can just stucco it.
And just have like a random hole right there? Yeah. No, that's weird.
Well, why don't we just do siding? We can match that siding. We'll give it a pop of color. What? I think it's a fantastic idea.
Siding inside the brick?
You see the siding that's there?
Yeah.
And that's up there? Just continue it right there.
You're talking about running the siding in between the bricks?
There's no other options.
It's look really weird. Look like a fake window.
So what do we do?
Honestly, I have no idea.
Finally, the small corner sink for the bathroom has just arrived.
It's actually smaller
Well, you know what? Now we're able to have a toilet in here where someone can actually wash their hands after they use it.
All right, I'll get installed today.
It's better than nothing.
Better than nothing. Well said. All right, honey, you think we're ready?
The door is really cute.
Yeah,
I love that color.
Hi. Hi, how you guys doing?
Good, I'm Tarek.
George.
Hi, Christina, nice to meet you.
We just listed the house today, 3-bedroom, 1.5-bath, $499.99. And we would love to get some feedback about the price, so take a look around and let us know if you have any questions.
All right, awesome. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, okay, wow, look at that tile.
A lot of space, a lot of counter space. That's wonderful.
You did a really good job with this. You don't see that with homes in this neighborhood.
The more that I look at the dining room, the bigger it seems to me.
Oh, I like what they did with the bathroom. I love this bubble tile on the floor.
Those tiles are so cool. Like, if I'm gonna share a bathroom with my kids for 20 years, yeah. I don't mind sharing this bathroom with them.
Wow, that's a small sink. Huh, it works. Kept the tile right in here, same colors.
It's the smallest sink I've ever seen.
Well, it's a sink though.
Okay, here's the first bedroom. I like that they ran the floors all the way through.
That's a really nice laminate. Really, very nice.
Second bedroom, wow. Through a closet with the window, that's nice. Really good size for the square footage.
Oh, very nice, very nice. Kids can play over there, you can have a dog, you can have the adults over here.
Do you like it?
And
yeah.
Then we could plant a garden and vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
This is really, really nice. They did an excellent job in here, I do have to say.
I think the open floor plan makes the fact that the house is so small feel much larger than it really is.
All right, so what'd you think?
Well done. Everything's nice and open. Do you like what you guys did with the color scheme?
What do you think about our list price?
This area is on upswing a little bit, so you guys are right there, because there's nothing that's clean in this area right now, especially under five.
Okay, awesome. Well, I would love for you to bring a buyer, and thank you for coming by.
Thanks, no problem.
Thank you.
This won't last long, so I gotta move fast.
All right, well, have a great day.